بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير ونشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله صفيه من خلقه وحبيبه اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا عدد ما أحاط به علمك وخط به قلمك وأحصاه كتابك وارض اللهم عن ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الصحابة أجمعين وعن التابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد أيها الإخوة المؤمنون إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Respected brothers and sisters, last Friday we started وَتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ. And inshallah I will try my best to make it a completion, not a repetition. There is one thing we need to highlight in at the beginning about Ibrahim alayhi salam, that Ibrahim alayhi salam ma kana Ibrahim yahudiyya wala nasraniyya. Sayyidina Ibrahim, he was neither a Jewish nor a Christian, bal kana hanifan muslima, but he was hanifa and he was Muslim, submitted himself to the will of his Lord. And last time we talked about Hanifa means مُقْبِلٌ عَلَى اللَّهِ مُعْرِضٌ عَنْ غَيْرِهِ. يعني his destination is always Allah, his direction is always Allah, and he doesn't care about anything else. And subhanAllah, the word Hanifa, it is one of the words that carry the meaning and the opposite at the same time. They say Hanifa mustaqima, straight. So Ibrahim alayhi salam kana Hanifa, he was straight. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, lead us to the straight path. At the same time, they say Hanifa is not the straight. It means the one who leans towards something. And when you lean towards something, that means you take the side of that something. And because of this, they say he was always leaning towards the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the Islam. And since Ibrahim alayhi salam was not a Jewish nor a Christian, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confirmed the religion of Ibrahim was Hanifa Muslima, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala logically addressed all the people. Because when you sit with people of religions, they all recognize Ibrahim, and everyone try to relay themselves to Ibrahim alayhi salam. as one of the evidences and the proofs that we have the right religion, because we are the followers of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it clear. Because Ibrahim alayhi salam, he didn't leave behind the wealth to be inherited. He left the legacy of the Messenger of Allah, which is his deen and his faith. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated, إِنَّ أَوْلَى النَّاسِ بِإِبْرَاهِيمَ لَلَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوا. So the worthiest of relaying themselves to Ibrahim, actually those who followed him. Followed him during his time. وَهَذَا النَّبِيُّ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And this Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and the believers with him. وَاللَّهُ وَلِيُّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the supporter of the believers. Likewise, your nasab, your lineage, being blood related to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, what is common among us as Sayyid, it's a great honor. But Abu Lahab, he was the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But the nasab did not help Abu Lahab. Abdul Muttalib, the one who raised Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam and protected him, even the will of Abdul Muttalib is to take care of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The nasab didn't really help. What did help is the right following of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Definitely, if you are blood related to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam and you are a true follower of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you got a great status. No one can compete with you about it. But the critical factor here is how far are you, or how close are you from ta'atullah and ta'atul Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. As with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated, وَكُلًّا نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الرُّسُلِ مَا نُثَبِّتُ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ. يعني the stories of the messengers, or the news of the messengers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, Muhammad, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relate to you. One of the wisdom behind these stories is لِنُثَبِّتَ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ, to make your heart firm. وَجَاءَكَ فِي هَذِهِ الْحَقُّ وَمَوْعِظَةُ وَذِكْرَى لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. They say, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought to you in this, that surah from the Quran, which is Surah Hud, or in the wahi in general, the revelation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed upon you. Then it will be the Quran from Alhamdulillah down to Surah An-Nas. What had been brought to you in this? Al-Haq, the truth. Wa maw'idha, admonition. Wa dhikra lil-mu'mineen, and a reminder for the believers. And because of this, they say, to watch your favorite channel, you must have a receiver. And the signal should be sent. You might have the best receiver, but there is no signal reach. You're still unable to watch. So they say al-qalb has to be firmed on the right path. Then the revelation came with truth, came with counseling, advice, admonition, came with a reminder. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed His blessings upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَى إِبْرَاهِيمُ. Recite upon them the news of Ibrahim. إذ قال لأبيه وقومه ما تعبدون. When he asked them, what do you worship? قالوا نعبد أصناما. We worship idols. فنظل لها عاكفين. We are proudly dedicating and devoting ourselves to it. قال هل يسمعونكم إذ تدعون. Do they listen to you? Can they hear you when you supplicate them? أو ينفعونكم أو يضرون. Can they give you benefit? Can they protect you from harm? Definitely there is no logical answer. Then they turn away in their conversation. They don't have a reliable answer for these minor questions. Then they responded to Ibrahim alayhi salam. قالوا بل وجدنا آباءنا كذلك يفعلون. We have found our parents, they doing exactly the same thing. So they were muqallideen, imitators for their parents. And as I mentioned before, scholars, they quoted from this verse or extracted from this verse, imitation is null and void, especially in the matters of i'tiqad. You have to spend efforts with istidlal and yaqeen. You have to run proofs and evidences. Otherwise, you are Muslim because your parents are Muslims, and the other one is Christian because his parents are Christians, and the other one is an atheist because his parents are atheist. So what is the favor that you have done? قالوا بل وجدنا آباءنا كذلك يفعلون. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala criticized that concept in the Quran. أم آتيناهم كتابا من قبله فهم به مستمسكون. يعني what keep them in their dalala, misguidance? Is that because we revealed an earlier book upon them, tell them to follow that misguidance? أم آتيناهم كتابا من قبله فهم به مستمسكون. بل قالوا إنا وجدنا وآباءنا على أمة. We have found our parents doing this. فَإِنَّ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Wallahi, they were guided, and guidance from our perspective is to just to follow their guidance. وَكَذَلِكَ مَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ فِي قَرْيَةٍ مِنْ نَذِيرٍ إِلَّا قَالَ مُتْرَفُوهَا. The same imitation which has no base for truthfulness. You cannot prove it with logic or thinking. إِلَّا أَنْ قَالُوا إِنَّا وَجَدْنَا آبَاءَنَا عَلَىٰ أُمَّةِ. We have found our parents doing the same thing. وَإِنَّا عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ مُقْتَدُونَ. Are their followers. So changing religion is not a good idea for them. The same thing the Christians and the Jews, they did. And subhanAllah, when you argue with someone on the wrong doctrine, so his goal is to win. But when he feels I cannot win, he acts like a catfish. You try to hold it from the head, then the tail is playing. And you try to hold it from the tail, then the head is playing. No way. وَقَالُوا كُونُوا هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارَى تَهْتَدُوا. Jewish people, they said, be Jewish. This is the manifest guidance. Christian, they said, be Christian. This is the right path. قُلْ بَلْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in another way is asking them, tell me which doctrine are you following? Are you following imitation? Then if you base on imitation, being a Christian or being a Jewish, then basically it will be much better for you to follow the religion of Ibrahim. Why? Because Christians and Jewish people, both of them, they are in disagreement about what they have. وقالت اليهود ليست النصارى على شيء وقالت النصارى ليست اليهود على شيء. Both of them denied what each group have. But when it comes to Ibrahim, both of them, they are in agreement about the belief in Ibrahim. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you were really imitators, then you would rather follow the religion of Ibrahim. Because following something both of you are in agreement about it is better than following something that you are both of you in disagreement about it. قُلْ بَلْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفَ. Say to them, that should be the religion of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And if you follow the istidlal and you follow the means of thinking, critical thinkers, and you swim in the ocean, your goal is to find the gem of the deen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed and He will accept, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in the Quran, Al-Haqq wal-Maw'idha wal-Dhikra lil-Mu'mineen. All the proofs had been revealed in this Quran to lead you to the straight path.
قَالُوا بَلْ وَجَدْنَا آبَاءَنَا كَذَلِكَ يَفْعَلُونَ قَالَ أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْبُدُونَ.
Have you seen what you have worshipped?
أَنْتُمْ وَآبَاؤُكُمُ الْأَقْدَمُونَ.
You and your forefathers. We mentioned this part last time and we said, Al-Batil remains Batil. The false remains false. It doesn't matter how old the idea of that falsehood, and it doesn't matter how new it is. It doesn't matter how minor are the followers of it, and how great number are the followers or in favor of it. Why? Because Batil is Batil.
إن الله لا يصلح عمل المفسدين.
Corruption cannot be fixed by another corruption. You have to deny it and denounce it and pick the right thing to do. Hopefully, your good deed after that will wipe out the sin that you committed earlier.
قالوا بل وجدنا آباءنا كذلك يفعلون. قال أفرأيتم ما كنتم تعبدون أنتم وآباؤكم الأقدمون فإنهم عدو لي إلا رب العالمين.
Look at yourselves. Look at what you are worshipping. They are enemy for me. Except رب العالمين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of all that exists.
They said, عَدُوٌ لِي.
First of all, your idols are my enemy. They say, maybe for one of these two reasons. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in Surah Maryam,
وَاتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ آلِهَةً لِيَكُونُوا لَهُمْ عِزَّا.
They adapt these idols to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they look at them that these are sinless creatures and they will pave our way towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who are we to talk directly to the Lord? We should have mediators. This is their thinking. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Kalla. This i'tiqad is fasid, corrupt.
سَيَكْفُرُونَ بِعِبَادَتِهِمْ وَيَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ ضِدَّ.
On the Day of Judgment, they will know the reality. There is no Lord that should be worshipped except Allah. And the izzah, the dignity and the honor they would like to get from worshipping them and getting them closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn upside down. They will gain nothing out of such worshipping except dhillah, humiliation and degradation. وَيَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ ضِدَّ. يعني they will harvest opposite of what they look for. And in the other, they say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will survive these idols. And when they talk back to the people, they will do two things. Number one, يُوَبِّخُونَهُمْ ثُمَّ يَتَبَرَّؤُونَ مِنْهُمْ. They will blame them. We never told you to worship us. And they will be innocent from the sin they committed. So the other point is, when they became satisfied with the wrong religion they have, worshipping the idols, that turned them away from seeking the right religion. And basically, they turn away from the way of happiness.
which finding in the straight path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَلَّا سَيَكْفُرُونَ بِعِبَادَتِهِمْ وَيَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ ضِدَّ. Then after that, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, he mentioned to them the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, some of Allah's attributes, that why I, Ibrahim alayhi salam, should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they say, Sayyidina Ibrahim, he said, عَدُوٌ لِي, an enemy for me. They say, Ibrahim alayhi salam would like to say to them, brothers, sisters, I got what you didn't get, and I have reached in knowledge, might not reach it you. And what I picked for myself is to worship Allah Rabbul Alameen. And I ask you and I invite you to worship that. So whatever I picked for myself, I did pick for you. And they say this is the climax of giving advice to someone. So if that someone turned away, say, okay, brother, why did you pick that for me? Said, brother, before yourself, I picked it for myself. This is how sincere Ibrahim alayhi salam was in his advice to his people. Then he mentioned to them, the Lord that you should worship should be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who I? الَّذِي خَلَقَنِي فَهُوَ يَهْدِينَ. The one who created me and the one who will lead me to the straight path. And subhanallah, see, khalq and hidayah. You don't know which one is greater than the other one. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is our Rabb because He created us. And He is our ilah because He led us to the straight path. The kafir on the day of judgment, he would love that the land will be balanced with his body. He's willing to give away everything just to be saved from the hellfire, not to be honored entering Jannah. So the hidayah is much more a greater favor of Allah than even the creation of the human. Because creation, being the creature, you can be the fuel of Jahannam. But being the creature whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed with guidance, you will be in Jannah, in paradise, with Nabiyeen and Siddiqeen and Shuhada and Salihin, with the highest status. What are you talking about? Khalq, without Hidayah, you wish being nothing. وَيَقُولُ الْكَافِرُ يَا لَيْتَنِي كُنْتُ تُرَابًا. The dream of the kafir, of the disbeliever on the day of judgment, wish being dust. It's over. But that dream cannot take place. So, hidayah is the main essence. الَّذِي خَلَقَنِي فَهُوَ يَهْدِينَ. And look at the secrets of the words of the Quran. They said خَلَقَنِي, mentioned in the past. The one who created me. فَهُوَ يَهْدِينَ, the one who is guiding me. One in the past, one in the present tense. They say, look, because in the dunya, you got created one time. The minute you come from the mother's womb, you are a new creature, inshallah, standing on your own feet. Allah doesn't create you every day. But hidayah, you might need the hidayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hundreds or thousands or billions of times every day. So the khalq is one time, but the hidayah is repeated. وَالَّذِي يُطْعِمُنِي وَيَسْقِينَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not only create me and lead me to the straight path, but He also supported me with the means of my survival. The ta'am and the sharab. He provided me with my food and with my water. حَتَّى تَقْضِيَ أَجَلَكَ. Till you reach your time. Then it's over. وَالَّذِي يُطْعِمُنِي وَيَسْقِينَ وَإِذَا مَرِضْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينَ. And when I become sick, He is the one who grants me recovery. With the rhythm, they say, supposedly to be, and when He makes me sick, He is the one who makes me recovered. They say, Ibrahim was polite addressing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The shortcoming from myself, and the blessings from my Lord. This is why he said, when I become sick, it can be my problem. Then recovery is a blessing. He attributed it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِي يُمِيتُنِي ثُمَّ يُحِينَ. And he is the one who will afflict me with death. And he is the one who will return me for my reward or for my punishment.
وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَحْيَاكُمْ ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ ثُمَّ يُحْيِيكُمْ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَكَفُورٌ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who created you the first time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who afflicted you with death. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be the one who return you. But first time to work and to follow the guidance. Second time is to be rewarded. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَكَفُورٌ. يعني misgratitude is attached to the human. The denial of the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a part of himself, to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala led to the straight path. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون قلت ما تسمعون فاستغفروا الله العظيم إنه هو البر الرحيم إن شاء الله. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء من شيء بعد. ربنا افتح بيننا وبين قومنا بالحق وأنت خير الفاتحين. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا. Respected brothers and sisters, وَالَّذِي أَطْمَعُ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ لِي خَطِيئَتِي يَوْمَ الدِّينِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that I look forward for him on the day of judgment to forgive my sin. And he said, my sin. We as Muslims believe that messengers and prophets of Allah, ma'sumun, they are sinless. Then why Ibrahim alayhi salam, he said, my khati'ah, my sin. They say, their sins are different than our sins. So when they do khilaf al-awla, this is a sin for them. Yani for example, fasting in the time he should run someone else's business on his behalf. So he did fast, or did salah, or did dhikr, and that stopped him from helping someone. And in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the catalog of the reward, going and helping someone more rewardable than the dhikr that time. So this, that considered a sin for them. Otherwise, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is the reason for him to seek the forgiveness of Allah day and night? What sin did he commit? They say, khilaful awla. They say, you seek the forgiveness of Allah in the dunya or akhirah. You seek the forgiveness in the dunya. You don't wait till the day of judgment comes and then you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these sins please forgive me. Everyone, oh Allah, forgive me in the dunya. So when I come to you, I come clean, purified. They say yes, the concept is right. He seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the dunya. But why he did say in the akhirah? Because the reflection of that forgiveness will not take place in the dunya. It will take place in the akhirah. Then they say Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam is teaching us how to make dua. First of all, he addressed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his great attributes. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who leads to guidance. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who feeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who reveals the water. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who gives the recovery. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who afflicts you with death. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who will survive you again. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be the one that forgives our sins. Then after addressing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like you need $1,000 from someone. Don't knock at the door and say, brother, I need $1,000. I don't have. But say, brother, mashallah, you are open-handed man. A lot of community members, they really praise you. A lot of people, alhamdulillah, you have an upper hand. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you like Rasulullah s.a.w. and the Sahaba ridwanullah alayhim. So you talk 5-10 minutes. Then after that, brother, I need $1,000 card hasan, inshallah, for 2 months. So the brother, he had to think. Why? Because that praise, 10 minutes, I don't want to delete it with no. I'd like to keep it. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, praising Allah. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, praising Allah. Malik Yawm Al-Din, praising Allah. Iyaka Na'bud Wa Iyaka Nasta'een, praising Allah. Then after that, lead us to the straight path. This is the way. Then they said, after all of this, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, he started looking back, making dua. I praised Allah, then this is my time to make dua. Rabbi habli hukma wa alhiqni bis salihin. Oh Allah, lead me. Hukm. Some of them of Sirin, they said Nubuwa, but they say he's already a prophet. And if a prophet asks for prophethood, it doesn't make no sense. They said Hukm, they said Kamal. Grant me perfection. The human perfection. And they say this is in Kamalul Ilm. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa qul rabbi zidni ilma. Like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Increase my knowledge. And the best knowledge existed is ilmu al-deen. An ta'lama an la ilaha illallah. Fa'alam annahu la ilaha illallah. So when you know that Allah is your Lord, you reach the climax of knowledge. Why? Because being a scientist in nuclear power, being the best physician existed, but you miss your Lord. Inshallah, the day you die, actually before your death, you will recognize that you spend the life of loss. There is no fruit out of it. So he said, Rabbi habli hukma, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, grant me the knowledge to know you, to know the shara of you. وَأَلْحِقْنِي بِالصَّالِحِينَ. And on the day of judgment, put me on the list of the righteous ones. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded, وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And on the day of judgment, Ibrahim alayhi salam on the akhirah will be among these righteous ones. رَبِّي هَبْ لِي حُكْمًا وَأَلْحِقْنِي بِالصَّالِحِينَ وَجْعَلْ لِي لِسَانَ صِدْقٍ فِي الْآخِرِينَ. And he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant him lisan, tongue, sidq of truthfulness, fil akhirin, by the end. They say this is his supplication to have Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they say the sahaba one time or one of the times they asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who are you? They would like to know Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more. They say, oh Allah's Messenger, attribute yourself to us. Then Rasulullah answered was, قَالَ أَنَا دَعْوَةُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَبُشْرَى عِيسَى وَرُؤْيَا أُمِّي آمِنَةُ. He said, I was the answer, the response of the supplication of Ibrahim. رَبَّنَا وَبْعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. So this is the supplication of Ibrahim alayhi salam. وَبُشْرَى عِيسَى. Sayyidina Isa ibn Maryam, when he went to the Jewish people, he told them, I have the pure version of the Torah and I have miracles for you. And at the same time, I carry the glad tidings of وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ إِسْمُهُ أَحْمَدٍ. This is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they say, while his mother was pregnant of him, she saw a light coming out from her. And the palaces of Asham had been enlightened for this. I know the time is over, and inshallah, it sounds like we still have the third part in this part, inshallah, to complete it. And basically, the coming part will be Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam meeting his father Azar on the Day of Judgment. And there is a conversation will take place. And this is authentic hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So inshallah, looking forward for the completion of Watlu alayhim Naba Ibrahim. So inshallah, it will be the third khutbah in this perspective and will be the last. As I mentioned earlier, we talk from the perspective of Surah Ash-Shu'ara. Otherwise, we can just keep talking about Ibrahim alayhi salam. وَإِنِّي دَاعٍ فَأَمِّنُوا. ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان واجعلنا من الراشدين. اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهديين لا ضالين ولا مضلين. اللهم إنا نسألك قبل الموت توبة وعند الموت شهادة وبعد الموت جنة ونعيما وملكا كبيرا. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينعى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واستغفروه يغفر لكم. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمني ويرحمكم الله.